Hi.
Good morning, guys. How are you doing? Hello. Thanks for having us on the show, by the way.
Of course, buddy.
Our absolute pleasure. Jake, we're a bit confused. What exactly is the girlfriend experience?
The boyfriend.
Well, it'll be
boyfriend experience
actually. Yeah. just to correct you there. It would be the boyfriend experience, and it's a million-dollar question. You know, I get asked all the time. You know, you've got to bear in mind that everyone's different in when it comes to clients and things. So the experience that they ask for is it's always tailored to that person. So you can have something from a Netflix and chill, you can have a candlelit dinner with champagne. You know, you could be going to somewhere, you know, on the Opera House, for example. So it's all very different, but I find that's the challenge in itself, and I love that challenge as well, trying to kind of figure out what's perfect for them. So it varies. It certainly varies every single person, which I like.
We should probably start from the beginning, but we were talking about the boyfriend experience, Denise and I, in the break, and wondering what it entails. So sorry to get straight into the nitty-gritty of it, but how did you actually get into this? Because you started doing some modelling.
Yeah.
Did you ever think that you would end up doing this as a career?
To be honest, I wanted to do it in the UK when I was 18 years old, so it's something I've always kind of had a big interest in. Coming to Australia and playing soccer, I did kind of dabble into modelling a little bit, and someone that was, you know, a part of the modelling crew, for example, they said, would you ever consider escorting? So they kindly pointed me in the right direction as to how big the market was in Australia and where to advertise. And then I kind of thought, instead of using all these platforms of other revenues and things, why can't I do it myself? You know, why can't I have an advertising platform myself for myself? So yeah, as much as I'm an escort as well, I've got a directory, I've got an active agency, and things went 0-100 very quickly, I can assure you right now, very quickly.
Is it true you've got a 6-month waiting list?
That is true. Yes, that is true. Sometimes it can be shorter, but is that not a good problem to have?
So talk to us about your clients. What sort of people are coming to you for your services?
It's varied. It's varied from age range from, I mean, it's got to be as young as 18, you know, you can't go anything below that, but it can be up to 60 years old. So it's a very varied kind of question that I get. But sometimes it's, you know, 40 years old, divorcees, business people, you know, people that work as veterinary nurses. So that there's a wide range to that answer, though, you know, but it's a huge amount of people, huge amount.
Have you ever found yourself falling for one of your clients?
Oh, well, I mean, I would say no, because you've got to be the ultimate professional. But what I would say is that what I do is very authentic and it's very genuine. So when you do book me, you know, my personal life to what I do, I'm very transparent. So you're getting the full version of me at all times, though, you know. So,
well,
yeah.
It seems as though it's going very well, Jake. So in your own mind, is this, like, is this going to be a long-term thing, or is this for you at the moment, work's going well, but eventually Jake is going to settle down with his person? Like, when does that start, or when does that bleed into each other?
I'm 32 years young right now, and I'm just getting started, right? So, you know, I'm 32 years young. So the plan is, like, the way I've got the company set up is, yes, I may be a male escort with a platform behind me, but I've kind of built it up as a brand. So, you know, think about the recurring revenue in a directory. You know, I've got an agency that I can actually physically send people out and work for a paid service. I've got an adult warehouse of toys, let's put it that way. That's another revenue stream. Then I've got online content. So the plan is when I eventually step away as Jake Ryan, the Jake Ryan Media becomes a brand in itself. So, you know, it's all about recurring revenue for when I do retire. I don't think I'll ever physically retire from the business, but yeah, that's the goal. That's the goal.
But like, it's a good thing. Like I said, you're being authentic. So you're not kind of, you're not like, I nearly said stiffing people there. Maybe yeah, I don't know. But you're not. You know, you're kind of. Now, what I mean is, you're being very authentic, and it's a positive thing. So it's like you're not duping anyone, should I say? Everyone knows what they're going to you for.
It's a service,
but
of course.
I just want to know. Say there's a 60-year-old woman like myself. That's a bit of a stretch.
No, you're not 60.
How much? How much does it cost for a night?
Asking for a friend, Denise?
Asking for a friend. You look on my website, my rates are there. But, look, my rates vary from $500 per hour, which is like a one-hour booking, but like then you've got an overnight package which can come up to $4,800. I respect each person's budget, so whichever kind of suits you, that's absolutely fine. You know, no one's better or worse off by booking me for an hour or booking me for 12 hours. Everyone's equal, you know.
Wow. Now, with this Me Too movement, is there a room for women in this industry?
Like, whatever
Jake does, I could do.
Of course, we've interviewed female.
I could do Netflix and supper.
Chill. Netflix and supper.
The industry is built by women. You know, that's the whole point. And the thing is with myself, I'm finding that I'm trying to mainstream women booking guys for escorting. You know, it's not a taboo thing. You're not doing anything wrong. And the industry is built on, you know, women being booked by males. But I'm trying to mainstream that as a whole, saying it's okay to look at an escort as your pleasure / companion. And once you educate people and make them feel comfortable that you're not doing the wrong thing. And quite frankly, when they walk away happy, they don't feel it's like a transaction. They feel they've done the right thing. Right. So walking in, they may be a bit nervous and things, but at the same time, it's like, oh, wow, it was actually really enjoyable. Yep. You know, he was genuine, and that's where I'm kind of sitting in the market right now.
Yeah, it's certainly not taboo anymore, and certainly we're seeing a lot more sex work within the disability sector as well, people who need that release, for want of a better word. Jake, you didn't come from a lot of money. You were raised by your beautiful single mum, and you actually send money back home to her. Yep. You bought her her first house, is that right?
I bought her what? Sorry, I didn't hear that.
Her first house.
Yes. Look, I mean, at the moment, I do financially support, you know, my family back home. It's not just my mother. I've got three sisters and quite a large family. But, you know, family comes first in my life. We can talk about the hourly rate that I get and the money I get left, right and centre, but you know, I give money back to my soccer team back in England. I sponsor them on the jerseys. Back to the family side of it, though, I do. I find that very important because it drives me on every day to go to work and, you know, to run my business and be successful.
What does your dear old mum think about what you do for a job in Australia?
She's proud of me. She's proud. I've got a great mother. She's a godsend of all women, though, you know. I was a little terror when I was growing up. But in terms of right now, she's very proud, so sometimes you do get a judgmental aspect in terms of what I do and you can't get away from that. But she, you know, addresses the question straight away. She's like, does your son do this? And she says, absolutely he does. And I'm proud of him, which is great.
I'm so fascinated by this. What about you? I mean, you're providing a service for people.
Yeah.
What about you? And do you have a relationship? Do you want to be in love with someone? And how do you maintain a relationship when this is what you do for a job?
It's difficult. It's a good question, but it's difficult because you've got to bear in mind, it's a little bit like a fake rock and roll lifestyle, and I don't mean to be arrogant saying that. What I'm saying is it's more the schedule. You know, I only spend sometimes 3 days in Melbourne and the rest I'm on tour, which is effectively going to Sydney, you know, Adelaide, Perth. I've got clients all over Australia, which I absolutely love. So to give someone your time and dedication in terms of relationship, it's quite difficult because you don't feel you're giving it your full self. I'm very much single, by the way, to answer your question. But
Are you looking for a girl?
I mean, Mother keeps on asking us. She keeps on saying, when are you going to settle down? I went, don't say that. Like, I'm good right now.
He doesn't want to. He's 32.
Yeah.
He doesn't want to.
That's it. I've got a great prospect coming in Friday, 5 p.m. We'll see how it goes. I think a lot of people won't understand it, you know, but who are they to judge? You know what I mean? So, like I said, you're not duping anyone. That's the point that I was trying to make. You're straightforward with people.
Yeah,
people
know what they're getting.
I mean, this is even a claimable, something you can claim through the NDIS, the National Disability Insurance Scheme. Because that's how important sex work is to some of the sectors.
There's funding there, by the way. There's funding and things for that, yeah.
Exactly. Yeah, Jake, you run the Adult Industry Awards as well. Who can be nominated for stuff like this? And do you have to be in the industry a long time? Ask for a friend.
Yeah. Yes. So you couldn't be nominated, by the way. But yeah, anyone within the industry can. So I was a previous winner in 2016 and 2017. And basically how it works is that anyone within the industry can be nominated, but you've got to be within that sector. So, you know, you can't be nominated for a top escort if you only do online content. It's a little bit different. I've got a committee behind me that we sift through all the nominations on a, you know, monthly basis and then kind of put that into fruition when the awards come around. But yeah, it's an open nomination policy and the public can vote. And the peers can vote as well. So, yeah, anyone can be voted and nominated.
And how's the soccer career gone?
I've retired now. I've retired. Right. And you've got to factor in, you know, when I started doing this, the soccer become less of a priority. I would love to have been a soccer player, but I wasn't that good. I was good, but not that good to be a pro. But the $500 per week in soccer, to that and his hourly rate in a career and a goal, what would you pick yourself, you know? Do I miss it? Absolutely. But yeah, my life's better now.
Yeah, sounds like you've got your hands full. Jake, what a nice guy you are. Thank you so much for joining us. You might even
thank you, guys.
Kicking new goals. Keep it up, buddy.
thank you, guys. Thanks very much. Stay safe.